Hello everybody, welcome. Thank you for joining us. So today I'm going to be doing my presentation. I'm going to talk about some of the things that I talk about when I bring up Arakon cameras and when I'm selling Arakon cameras. Also, I'm going to talk about my post-pitch process and what we do generally for every job, but specifically for Jonathan Alder High School. This is traditionally known as the How I Shot the Bear presentation. I would just like to say that no bears were harmed during the making of this presentation. And I do not have controls of the PowerPoint, just so the guys are, there it goes, now it's coming up. So there's your bear right there. Moving on, next slide. So the customer is Jonathan Alder High School. Normally the PowerPoint would have this as a video playing, but I guess it can't handle it. But normally you'll see that it's going to be going around in the 360. So this is the read-along portion. I put a video in so you guys don't get bored, but I'll read along anyway. Here we go. The customer is Jonathan Alder High School, and they were looking for a camera system to allow them to actually identify people in and out of their school for both internal incidents and external threats, as well as give them full situational awareness. The challenge of schools are the budgetary restraints that all schools face. Our job is to make them appreciate why megapixel solutions are more expensive than analog systems and why they should spend the extra money. Too often, decisions are made based solely on budget and not on images and results. Schools are frugal, and they have to be. From what I understand, they mostly get their money from grants that need to be spent by a certain date. The majority of the time, schools will always go with the lowest or second to lowest bidder, unless they are shown something that stands apart from the competition. While our Arakon cameras are priced fair, we are certainly not the least expensive or the most expensive option. The true challenge, like with all sales calls, was to make the customer truly appreciate that you do indeed get what you pay for. So far, the customer has installed the following cameras. Phase two is already becoming specified. And what you're going to see on the screen there is a shot that Ashley Deidesheimer, our inside sales coordinator, took. They have a couple parking lots, which I'll show you those shots. But for us to truly achieve situational awareness plus, it looks like it's going to take 10 megapixel cameras with 35 millimeter lenses on it to get that situational awareness plus. Some of the special applications include the large outside of the school, including the parking lots, bus drop-offs, and general surveillance around the school. So we took this shot from SMC1, our company drone, and the reason why I showed this shot specifically before I show you two actual shots is it has a couple of visual cues. So if you look, we have three walkways there, we have the bus drop-off area, and then the entire parking lot. So I took my drone and I put it right next to the Arakon camera to get a shot to show you what it would look like if we had a single sensor image. Now, look at what we're seeing. Look at the differences what we're seeing, and I'll show you the actual Arakon picture in a second, but now we have one walkway. You think we're getting a pretty decent shot of the parking lot, but look at those cars on the right-hand side. And look, I don't know if you can see my mouse on the screen, but you can see that these are the two cars here. These are the cars here. Look how much we're missing of the entire parking lot. Look how much we're missing of the entire bus drop. Well, forget about the fact that we're literally seeing one walkway. With the Arakon camera, and this is an installed shot, the surround video camera, we're getting everything. We're getting all three walkways. We're getting the hangout areas in the front of the school, the entire bus drop-off area, and the entire parking lot with one camera. So I'm going to go through some of the things that I talk about specifically when I'm selling Arakon cameras and talk about how we got these cameras installed, like you're seeing them right there. The first thing that I like to talk about is the history of the company. Not just how long they've been around, but this slide is very powerful because it shows that Arakon Vision is not a company that rests on their laurels. They're constantly making improvements, just like we saw on the Omni camera. They're constantly making changes. Every single year, either there's a new technology coming out or they've revamped one of their older technologies. And I think that's important because, again, it's not a company that sits back and says, we've got it, we're good. They're constantly improving and making changes. But even more important than that, I believe, is the industry firsts. Arakon is the only company I can think of that truly does have a vision in our industry. They're the first 2-megapixel camera. They were the first company to use H.264 across an entire line of megapixel cameras. But what I've highlighted here is what I always start with when I'm talking about Arakon cameras, and that's the surround video cameras, specifically the 180-degree camera. The cameras are unbelievable. No one's ever done it before, and I think that's important to start with when we're talking about these cameras. And they use biomimicry. Now, you may be asking, what is biomimicry? And Arakon may or may not have used biomimicry on purpose, but biomimicry is the imitation of the models, systems, and elements of nature for the purpose of solving complex human problems. Now, I don't know if Arakon used biomimicry when they created these cameras, but even if they did it by accident, to me, that's even more impressive. So let me give you a couple quick examples of what biomimicry is, just so we can wrap our heads around it. When humans looked at the sky and started thinking about flight, Leonardo da Vinci looked at bats and started creating gliders that can do that. The Wright brothers studied a guy named Otto Lilienthal, who all looked at birds and created gliders based on birds. I guess these animations were a bad idea, but obviously we got the sonar from the Dolphin. Believe it or not, Velcro was invented when George Mishral took a burdock burr, put it under a microscope, and saw that they had these hooks in there, and in 1952, Velcro was invented. Believe it or not, the bullet train did look completely different when it was first made. When the bullet train was first made, it looked like a regular train, but it was incredibly loud. And specifically when it went through a tunnel, it would create a gunshot noise when it came out of the tunnel. So one of their engineers, Eiji Nakatsu, was a bird watcher, and he noticed that when the kingfisher bird dove into water to get fish, it barely created a ripple. Aquadynamics and aerodynamics go hand in hand. So what they did is they put a 50-foot long steel kingfisher beak in the front of the bullet train. It got rid of the noise problem, reduced power dramatically, and enabled faster speeds. Speaking of aquadynamics, what you're about to see on the screen coming up, wait for it. This ridiculous looking fish is the boxfish. Mercedes-Benz is copying it and making a car that's the most aerodynamically superb car on the planet thanks to that ridiculous fish. But now, why am I bringing up all this stuff? The biomimicry that applies to this presentation is that of the human eye and the invention of the camera. And I think by showing some of these slides, it truly shows you how unique Arakon is and how they think about going about business and making this technology. So a quick history lesson just to truly appreciate how unique Arakon is. The first ever pinhole camera, the first ever camera ever, was created in 1021 by Ibn al-Hathim. Louis Le Prince invented the first ever film camera in 1888. In 1942, a bunch of German engineers created the first ever CCTV system. You have Walter Bruch, Wayne Cox, Tashar Arnold, the first ever CCTV system. Now, since the invention of the camera, there's been improvements, there's been changes. We've gone from film to digital, from digital to megapixel, but every single manufacturer, my humble opinion, missed the all-important cue that Arakon picked up on, and that is that nothing in nature was intended to be made or born with one eye. And we're pretty sure the Cyclops doesn't exist in the first place, so we can't use that as an example, but let me give you a real-world example of how hard nature sticks to the plan of having at least two eyes. What you're seeing on your screen right now is a flounder. They swim like regular fish until they reach adulthood. Once they reach adulthood, they get to the bottom of the ocean, and if you can see my mouse on the screen, what you're seeing here, these are the pectoral fins, the bottom of the fish. This is the top of the fish right here. If you look, its mouth is sideways because the fish now lays on the bottom of the ocean floor like this 24/7 nonstop. Nature literally moves its other eye permanently over and around to achieve stereo vision. It's that important to nature's plan. Weird looking fish. So what does this all mean? For 985 years since the invention of the first camera, every great mind that ever touched a camera, every great manufacturer, missed that all-important cue that, once again, Arakon picked up on. Like, nothing in nature is intended to be made with one eye. Everything has at least two eyes. Arakon took nature's cue, again, whether on purpose or by accident, and made it better, dramatically better. So I'm going to show a quick example that I know everyone has seen this picture before, but I love showing this picture for a couple reasons. If you had a VMS right now, you can dive in. You could see the people's faces. You could see inside and outside. The wide dynamic range is in full action. You could see every cloud in the sky, every single palm tree. But if this was a single sensor camera, that's the shot you get. Again, with these Arakon 180-degree cameras, look what you're getting. It becomes a Where's Waldo, where the people. You see all these people in here. You can get face shots across the board, people all hidden all over the place. And look at this shot. It's beautiful. And what I love about this, and I think that myself up until a few months ago, and I think potentially a lot of Arakon people took for granted, is how much better these cameras are than even our vision, than even the human eyes. So you may be watching this right now and you may have 20/20 vision, you may be wearing your glasses, but regardless of that, these cameras are dramatically better than the human eyes. So I'm going to show you with a little bit of science time. This morning I actually changed this to three pictures of Theodor Brahms. I have an award that I got, and it's a picture of Theodor Brahms from the Arakon CrossFit Awards, but there wasn't enough time to change it, so I brought up these three bears. What I want everyone to do is focus on this bear in the middle right here. Do not take your eyes off that bear in the middle, but what I want you to do is use your peripheral vision to try to get the other bears in focus. And what you're seeing almost immediately is that that middle bear is in focus because you're staring at it. The other two bears are completely out of focus. Now, this isn't a trick. Let's go over here to the bear on the left-hand side, lock eyes with that sad bear, and try to get the bear in the middle in focus. And the answer is you just can't. And the reason why is the human eyes only have the ability to see less than 10% in high resolution, less than 10%. Our brain does an amazing job of tricking us to thinking that everything that's in our sight is HD, but it's not. And if you think this is cool, you want to show people at home, take your hand right now, extend it out as far as you can, spread your fingers out as far as you can, and lock your eyes on your middle finger. Even with using your hand example, your middle finger now is completely in focus. The fingers on the side, including the pinky and the thumb, are completely out of focus. These cameras are dramatically better than anything that nature can achieve right now. Look at that shot. I got this on the Archon website, but everything is sharp. Everything is in focus, and the color reproduction is beautiful. So once I'm done doing my pitch, once I'm done showing the cameras live and setting up the cameras live, oops, I guess I skipped a slide there. Sorry about that. I skipped ahead a little bit. So one more active biomimicry that I do have to talk about is the chameleon. The chameleon can change its colors. Everyone knows that. But what some people don't know is that the chameleon can actually independently move its eyes in whatever configuration that they want. I think once again, whether they knew it or not, Archon found that in biomimicry, copied it, even if by accident, and made it worlds better. I mean, that's the Omni camera right there. All right, so once I'm done with the pitch, my post-pitch process is as such. I offer the dealer and the end user to go do a walkthrough with them. And what I think is important about that walkthrough is that we name every single location and then put the exact camera that we recommend there. The reason why we do that specifically with schools is that a lot of times schools have to do these jobs in phases. By breaking it down like this, now the dealer and the end user can sit down after they get the actual quote, the registered quote, and they can say, you know what, maybe we'll do these first three cameras in phase one, we'll do these cameras in phase two. It just allows us to at least get the sales process started. I take these notes, I send it to Ashley Dottesommer, our inside sales coordinator. She puts them in a nice Word document, writes a sweet little email to the end, to the dealer, I should say, and then what she'll do is take this and put it into a Word document, or an Excel document, I should say. And then what you're seeing here in the Excel document is the quantity of the cameras, it is MSRP, but more importantly, it's the full part number and then the actual Archon Vision description. So now they're not going in blind. If it takes 2 or 3 months of the school to close, they have all the information that they need to intelligently talk to the end user. So here are some shots from the actual job site. This one on the top left, you've seen already, but look at some of these shots. Now we have a lot of grass here and that's totally intentional. Schools have kids hanging out in all the areas, including the parking lot, so these shots were specifically designed to see everything in the shot. We have one in the gym as well. We have a couple cameras in the gym, and what's happening now, not with Jonathan Oliver High School, but with some other schools, is that a lot of the coaches are seeing these cameras in high resolution, and they're starting to use these cameras for actually coaching. So they'll record a basketball game, basketball practice, they'll put it in the football field, and then go back, and if their VMS has an HD screen recorder, they can literally break down the game or break down the practice for the students, which is pretty cool as well. A couple of quotes from the customers. The surround video camera is a high quality camera in a small package. It is barely noticeable on the side of the building and in our gym. The HD quality of the picture makes the Archon surround video camera stand out among other cameras that we demoed. So I don't know why Archon Vision named their company what they named it. Number one, I have no idea what an Archon is. I looked it up and I asked Google. Google kind of shrugged at me. No clue what Archon is, but that's not what I'm talking about. I think it's a cool name, Archon. I'm talking about the vision part. Did they call it Archon Vision simply because it's a camera manufacturer? Or did they call it Archon Vision because this is the only company, and think about it, the only company that has truly changed the world, changed our industry, and changed the way people thought about it. The only company with visionaries. The thing is, if you are a visionary, you do inherit the ability to change the world, to change the way people think about technology, the planet, and how technology should work. Personally, when I think of Archon Vision, I don't think they use the name Vision because of the cameras. I think it has nothing to do with the fact that they make cameras. I think it's because it is a company that truly does have a vision. Either way, it doesn't matter. My name is Scott Cappelletti. I work for Security Marketing Consultants, and we are proud representatives of Archon's vision. Thanks, everybody. Have a good day.